The Reverend Fathers, the Mayor of the Gupan City, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Katulad ng alam na ninyo, bakit mayroong imahe ng Birhen ng Manaoag sa Dagupan, ang totoo pong nangyari ay noong delikado ang mahal na Birhen sa Manaoag at sinisira ng mga revolusyonaryo ang simbahan at pinagpaplanuhang sunugin ang simbahan, ang imahe ng Birhen ng Manaoag ay itinago dito sa Dagupan para maligtas doon sa maninira at susunog ng simbahan. At nung tahimik na po ang Manaoag, pagkatapos ng ilang araw ay ibinalik ang Birhen ng Manaoag sa Manaoag at hanggang ngayon ay doon pa rin siya nakatira. Pero tayo dito sa Dagupan, hindi natin makakalimutan na nung nangangailangan ang ating ina, ay Dagupan ang kanyang tinakbuhan. Nung nangangailangan ang ating ina, ay mga taga-Dagupan ang nagtago, nagligtas, at nagkupkup sa kanya. At yung binasa po nating gospel, sa huli ay sinabi, "And the disciple took her into his home." Yun po ang nangyari mahigit 100 taon na ang nakakalipas. Dagupan took Our Lady into our home. Sa harap po ng ating altar ng katedral, makikita natin yung imahen na iba sa Birhen ng Manaoag. Ano po ito? It is Mary standing at the foot of the cross. Nabasa po natin ang gospel. Our Lady did not say anything. She just stood there. She stood beneath the cross. And standing beneath the cross is not just a pious picture. Standing beneath the cross is a very powerful statement. How can we understand the meaning of Mary standing at the foot of the cross? First and foremost, please remember, she was standing. She was not sitting. She was not kneeling. She was not subdued. She did not surrender. She stood up and she remained standing. The other apostles ran away. But the first among the disciples, and that is the Virgin Mary, remained standing at the foot of the cross. But after looking at Mary standing silently at the foot of the cross, we must also remember she did not say anything. Nothing in the scriptures is recorded that she said something. Bakit mahalaga po na bigyan natin ng pansin na ang mahal na Birhen ay nakatayo at tahimik? Bakit? Sapagkat yung buong paligid ay maingay. Yung buong paligid ay minumura ang kanyang anak. At doon sa paligid na nagmumura sa kanyang anak, ang ilan doon nagmartilyo pa ng pako sa kanyang kamay at sa paa. If you are a mother seeing your son being nailed to the cross, our normal behavior is to complain. Our normal behavior is to fight back. Our usual behavior is to say, hindi dapat mangyari yan. O kung Pinoy, ang mahal na Birhen, siguro hahanap ng koneksyon papunta kay Pilato at sabihing, ibubulong, "Sir, baka naman ho pwedeng bawiin na yung death sentence." Pwedeng makiusap, pwedeng magprotesta, pwedeng magmura, pwedeng labanan ng galit yung galit sa kanyang paligid. But the Virgin Mary stood and remained standing and kept quiet. What was she teaching us and what was she doing? She is saying to us, there comes a point in our lives when you cannot handle darkness anymore, when darkness really sets in. Dumarating sa buhay natin na hindi natin mapipigil ang kamatayan, hindi natin mapipigil ang sakit, hindi natin mapipigil ang matalo, hindi natin mapipigil ang masaktan. Dumarating sa buhay natin na hindi natin mapipigil yung pagmumura ng kapwa-tao, yung paninira ng kapwa-tao, yung pagsisinungaling ng kapwa-tao. At kapag ganito na ang sitwasyon, what should we do? The Virgin Mary did not transmit another anger. Rather, the Virgin Mary transformed the anger and became a symbol of peace. The Virgin Mary absorbed all the bitterness, but she did not allow any bitterness to come out of her mouth. The Virgin Mary saw a lot of violence, but she did not allow violence to come out of her lips. She did not demonstrate. She did not rally. She did not say bad words. She did not curse. She only stood there peacefully, absorbing all the bitterness and telling them, in the face of bitterness, I will be your peace. In the face of violence, I will be your peace. In the face of greed and selfishness, I will be your peace. In the face of murder, I will be your peace. In other words, brothers and sisters, each time you see Mary standing at the foot of the cross, that is not about doing nothing. It is about being more powerful than violence. It is about being more powerful than greed. It is about being more powerful than pride. It is about being more powerful than death. Kung hindi natin mapipigilan ang kamatayan, ang kirot, manindigan tayo at sasabihin natin, batuhin ninyo ko kahit anong gusto nyong ibato, pero hindi ko kayo lalabanan ng bato. Lalabanan ko kayo ng aking kapayapaan. Murahin ninyo ako hanggang gusto ninyo, pero hindi ko kayo mumurahin sapagkat magwawakas ang mura sa pagtanggap ko at hindi ko kayo mumurahing pabalik. I will not transmit, I will transform your violent anger. I will not fight back, I will rather be a symbol, be a reminder of peace, of harmony, and mercy. Ang tanong ay, ganun ba talaga dapat natin gawin? The Virgin Mary was not a pacifist. The Virgin Mary was not a passive disciple. She stood up for something greater than violence. She stood up for something bigger than murder. She stood up for something bigger than sin. And what is that? Peace in the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, pagkatapos po ng misa, babasbasan ang lahat ng may sakit. Yung iba ay gagaling. Yung iba ay hindi gagaling. Ganun po talaga ang takbo ng mundo. Pero kung sakaling gumaling, magpasalamat. Pero kung sakaling hindi gumaling, tularan natin ang Mahal na Birhen. Nakatayo, malakas ang loob na nakatayo. At sasabihin, I absorb all bitterness and sickness and pain. But I will not transmit. I will not be a channel. I will not conduct pain for others. In the midst of sickness, pain, and suffering, I will be peace.